9. 2 thirds h minus 1 third h plus 11. Is this the right one? Equals 8. Okay. Give people who started out of hand, people put an end to it. Didn't get too crazy and loud in here. Okay. So, what should we do first?
Subtract 2/3 h minus 1/3 h.
What would we get?
1/3 h.
1/3 h. That's kind of it's almost a new idea. What do you guys think
plus
of that?
Plus 11.
Yeah.
Let's just talk about 2/3 h minus 1/3 h is 1/3 h. Is that, what do you think? You agree?
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Yeah?
Yep.
Yeah. Okay, I agree too. Yeah. So there's 2/3 of an h minus 1/3 of an h leaves 1/3 of an h. Plus 11 equals 8. So 1/3 h equals negative
3.
Three.
I forgot to do that part.
And then divide.
Divide?
3 over 1.
By what?
3 over 1.
Divide by 3 over 1?
Or more.
What's 1/3 divided by 3?
3.
By 1.
1.
It's
no, multiply.
9.
Oh, multiply by 3 over 1. So there's two things that this, they are equivalent to each other. I could divide by what?
3.
1/3, right? 1/3 divided by 1/3 is
same.
Is what?
1.
That's what we want. We want to do 1x. Well, I can get a 1x by multiplying 1/3 by 3 over 1 as well. Right?
Yeah.
Because I get 3 over 3, that's 1. Okay. So dividing by 1/3 or multiplying by 3 over 1, same thing. Multiplying by the reciprocal. So multiply both sides by 3 over 1. I like multiplying by the reciprocal. I think it's just a little bit cleaner and simpler. So this is going to be a 1h. Negative 3 times 3?
Negative 9.
Make sure it's a negative. All right. Next we had 11. Sorry, I had those in the wrong order, didn't I?
Mm-hmm.
I had 12 and then 11.
Sorry, 21.
21 times 2 minus x. Plus 12x equals 44. Matt has to take it away.
Me?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Go for it.
You do 21 times 2, that would be 42.
Uh-huh.
And it's gonna be a minus or minus. I'll just say 21 because you're doing 21 times x plus 12x.
What? You forgot the x.
At 21.
Here?
Yeah.
21x.
21x?
Yeah,
okay.
44.
What's this called? What did we just do in this step?
Distribution.
Distribution. Okay. Keep going, Max.
Well, then you take out the 42 and minus it from 44.
So subtract 42 from 42 and subtract 42 from 44. We get negative 21x plus 12x equals 2.
Then you add those up and it'll be like a negative 9x.
Okay.
It'll equal 2. So then you divide it by negative 9.
Very good.
And after that you get 2 over 9.
Negative 2 over 9. Very good. And we're not writing fractions, so we're trying to write it as a decimal, leave it as a fraction.
Good.
Any questions there? Distribute, combine like terms, and then what you have there is basically a two-step equation. Next, we go to 15, right? Or no, 14?
14.
14. Okay, so we draw a very simplified version of this house that they're showing us. This house is a two-story house. And let's see, it's saying that from the bottom of the roof to the top is 6 feet. From the floor level up to the, I guess, the ceiling of the first floor is x. From the floor of the second floor to the ceiling of the second floor is also x. So you go up and down the stairs here, the ceiling will be the same height, whether you're on the first floor or the second floor, okay, because they're the same height. It also says that the entire height of this house is 26 feet. So if you go over here, from here to there, all the way from the top to the bottom is 26 feet. And then wants to know what's the height of each floor, each story of the house. So we're gonna set up some equation that we can solve, right? You might be able to just intuitively see what the answer is supposed to be, but we are practicing equations. We're trying to get that experience. Right? Who taught us that lesson? That lesson yesterday. Don't be afraid of algebra. Okay, so what's the equation? What equation can we write knowing that each story is x and the roof is 6 and the whole thing is 26? Cole?
It could be like x plus 6 equals 26.
I love that equation. Just adding up all of the heights and you get the whole height. Hunter?
I did.
Let's just start from what we see on the board. So what we could do with what's written on the board. With what's written on the board, what could we do from what's written on the board? Rather than ignoring Cole's word. Sid?
Oh, I was just going to ask if you could do 2x.
Well, we could talk about that, but I want you to take what Cole has done, take it further. And then we'll talk about, you know, Hunter did this, Sid did this, and see if it's the same as what we did on the board. Okay. Jasper?
There's a new one today. You could put the x's together.
X plus x.
Would be 2x.
Which would be 2x. So now, whose question does that answer?
Sid's
question, right? Can it be a 2x? Right? Can it be a 2x?
Yeah.
Yes. X plus x is 2x. So if you said, well, I see there's 2x's, so 2 times x plus 6. That way. Now what would we do?
You would
minus 6. Sounds like we're all eager to do that. Okay, well, that looks like 26. That's supposed to be 20. 2x equals 20.
Divide by
2. 2, let's go. X is 10. Okay, we always have to make sure, especially with word problems, that is the question. Sometimes they'll ask us a different question after we figure out what x is, but let's see. Find the height x of each story. So yeah, that is correct. Sometimes they'll say what's the height of both of the stories, or is it the volume of the house, or something like that, where that is not just as simple as finding x. But this time, that is it. That's the question. We answered the question. Now, Hunter, what did you do?
Oh, that was
fine.
I thought I was going to do. Well, yeah,
okay. Great. Work together. If you didn't start with x plus 6 equals 26, I just challenge you to think, is the thing that I did the same as this? Okay. We've been taking notes and stuff. That's good. Let's clear our desks. Ready? First, what are we doing number one? Allie. 6x? 3 equals 4, so I'm going to take it from there.
14.
Oh, 14. Whoa, whoa,
whoa. It's 14.
What's that? 14? Fixed it. Brandon?
Then you take minus 6.
Minus 6?
Or plus.
Wait. Plus 6?
No, minus 6, yeah.
Minus 6?
What?
Minus 6 on each side.
Okay, what's the next line going to look like?
0, or x.
X
equals.
You're supposed to have plus 3.
Eight.
The plus is divide.
Equals to x equals
8?
No.
Well, for one thing, what happened to this 3?
It's
still there.
And it's 6x minus 6. Let's look at 6x minus 6. Is that something?
No. Oh, yeah.
Something. Can I put it together?
No.
Why not?
Ones can't go with x's.
Ones can't go with x's. The best answer. Oh my gosh. good reminder that ones can't go with x's. So if I were to subtract 6 from 6x, it would not be x. Okay, that's one thing. So that doesn't give us an x. Also, you know, the negative 3 seems to just disappear there. Let's back it up. What could we do instead of subtracting 6? Because that's
plus 3 on each side.
So what's negative 3 plus 3?
0.
0. 1's going with 1, leaves us with just 6x on this side. We add 3 to the other side, which 17. We had better do. We get 17. We divide by 6. 6 divided by 6 is 1. Now we have 1x equals 17 over 6.
I'm just
going to
say 17. Yes?
Oh, wait, so yeah, it's correct if you turn that into decimal?
Yeah.
Once is exactly the right decimal. If you round, it's not right. Because this is not equal to a rounded off fraction. Now, if we divide 17 by 6,
that's
2n.
17 divided by 6.
It doesn't come out.
2.83 repeating, so if you want to get it correct.
With a line over the top.
Yes,
I
did it!
Otherwise, I will take credit off. Because for one thing, I keep telling you over and 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 over to leave it as a fraction. To not be afraid of fractions. I'm just asking you to leave your answer as a fraction. You don't even have to add it to another fraction or multiply it by another fraction. Just say leave it as a fraction. Okay? If you turn it into a decimal, then it better be exactly right. Now, at least one exception to that kind of thing is if I actually was telling you x was 17 sixths somethings, like gallons or miles or something like that, then it would make more sense to say something in decimals, 2.83 miles. Okay, so I can have this scope of what we're even talking about. I know about how big a mile is, so 2.83 miles, I kind of know how far that is, right? Or gallons, okay, I got an idea of how many gallons that is. But if it's just a number, just as an exercise to solve an equation, you just leave it as a fraction. Yeah?
So if we just put 17, it'd be wrong.
Just 17? Yeah. You didn't get a 6.
Okay.
Hell yeah.
What? Why didn't you have a 6?
Oh, I don't know.
I can't remember. It is 76. That's the answer there. Okay, number 2. What should we start with number 2? Mark is going to start us off.
Can I read the distribute the maybe?
Vocabulary.
Negative 6.
Negative 6x plus good. Plus 2x equals 8. Okay?
So you plus the negative 6x with the 2x, which is 3 and 4x.
Exactly. 15 equals 8. And Mac?
We do negative 15.
Subtract 15. Okay, so negative 4x equals negative 7.
And then divide.
Except for the dividing, I like the dividing. That's good. Divide by negative 4, divide by negative 4. Negative 4 divided by negative 4 is 1x. Negative 7 divided by negative 4 is?
Negative 7.
1.
No, 7. 7 fourths. Positive 7 fourths. Negative divided by negative is positive. Subtraction 7 fourths is a positive number.
I changed that one to.
Yeah, I got 1.75.
1.75? Yeah.
Yeah.
That's correct.
You
don't even need a line over that one, right? I'm not against decimals. I'm just against the fear of fractions. Okay, so afraid of fractions. And if you're avoiding them, I'm gonna make it hard for you to avoid them as hard as I can make it. Being unfair. Okay. Feel good about combining like terms before you move on solving the equation and
yeah.
Distributing before you move on to solve the equation?
Sure.
Are you okay about it?
Yep.
Good.
Sure.
I honestly
not
understand
any of those. Same. When we were doing
I'm being honest and it just kind of right here.
I honestly understand. Honestly, what you ought to be doing is speaking up more, asking more questions, and I imagine you knew this when you were doing your homework, that you knew that you were having trouble. You should be coming in before school or after school and asking questions about those things, or so much that you can do, you have to speak up more. You gotta say more. I mean, I can't reasonably take more class time to go over more and more and more. We had class time, and then we had practice problems, and then we had homework, and then we had going over homework questions, and then we had a homework review, and now we've been over the homework review. And I'm not saying that it's impossible to still be confused about it, but you gotta take a more proactive approach, right? So, if you wanna go from being a little bit confused right now to being less confused, then let's take some time out of your lunch, or out of your before or after school, or I don't know if you have an academic extension, or
yeah.
I don't know.
Yeah, we have academic.
Take one of those, lots of time, come down here, or if we can't make the time to work out, I'd be glad to like make some videos for you that I can post on YouTube. You can watch those and just out there.
Are we allowed to come here in academic? Do you have anything first period?
First period I have a prep, so that works really well.
What is prep?
Prep is the time that I have to plan for classes. So I don't have any students that time. Right? Be proactive about it. I know it can be frustrating, but get in there. And when you are more proactive and you get the point where you're kind of caught up, then you need that outside help a little less and a little less and a little less. There's also this homework help where? At the church.
At the church.
At the church after school. Okay, so there's that too. I mean, if you're able to do that, if you're here for that, you can come over here. Or if you want to arrange it so that I come over there, that, I'm glad to come over and help.
And there's after school homework help for, I don't know which days they have it, but Miss Pettit and Miss Miller are doing it after school as well.
So check with Miss Pettit and Miss Miller about that. Okay. Well, what I have, the only other thing that I have, just a couple of pictures that I want you to, if you really got after it, you could get some stuff done right now. Okay? Now, as I look around the room, I'm a little sad because what we should have been doing all this time is taking notes. Okay. Let me explain something real quick. You do your homework. Then you give it to me. After you give it to me, we move on to homework questions. Right? So you should be taking notes on your homework. Then the next day, when I pass it back to you, okay, when you had a question about number 15, and we did number 15, we did 14 in this class. Number 14, and then we did number 14 in this class, right? You get your homework back. And you compare your notes to your homework. And you see, I see what I did wrong there because I took notes about it. Right. Then we move on. After we take notes, right, we do the homework review. Hopefully you do well there. Then you hand it in to me, and after that we take notes on the homework review. That's what you ought to have been doing just now, because unless you're just super duper confident that you've done everything correctly in the homework review, you probably should have been taking notes, because tomorrow you're going to get your homework review back and you're going to compare your homework review to the notes that you took, right?
Yep.
Your notes will be, if you had taken them, exactly
the same.
Well, exactly the same, yeah. We did those problems from the homework review in the notes. Shouldn't have taken those notes, okay? Unless you're supremely confident, you just never make mistakes. Unless that is you, you should be taking notes, okay? And comparing when you get it back to your notes. Okay, enough of that. Nope, don't want that today. Right. I'm going to draw a couple pictures. You should write these down because this is your homework today.
Yeah.
Yay.
What?
Okay, so here's ultimately what you're going to do is find X. I think that's pretty obvious, right? Can anybody tell me what X is for either of these rectangles?
No.
Why not?
Because we don't have any information.
We don't have any information. Keep in mind, in like never trust a picture just the way it looks, okay? Because it was ultimately made by a person, and that person may not have drawn it to scale.
And they wanted.
And when you look at a map, you ever looked at a map before of the
yeah.
world? It's wrong. No matter which one you're looking at, it's wrong. Unless you're looking at a globe and you're calling the globe a map, okay? Every map is wrong.
Because they're not circles.
Because they're not circles, there is no perfect way to put a sphere onto a plane and make it look right. So the Mercator projection, the Greenland looks massive. Greenland looks like it's almost as big as Africa. It's not.
Okay.
It's just, so don't trust the picture. If this looks like 4, maybe it is 4, maybe it's not. But just because it looks the same as this doesn't mean that it is. Okay. And keep in mind, what I want you to do here is write equations and solve equations, right?
Mm-hmm.
Keep that in mind as I keep telling you this information. So, this rectangle has an area and a perimeter. That's what we're going to use. This rectangle has an area and a perimeter. Two different problems. They're not related to each other. But for both of these, the area is equal to the perimeter. Now, I don't know what the area is, I don't know what the perimeter is. Right? I can't say that the area is 50. I have no way of knowing that. I don't know. But, here's what I can say in the last 30 seconds. You do know how you would find the area, you do know how you would find the perimeter if I told you what x was, right?
Yeah.
You know what you would do. So you do all that stuff, you just do it with x, right?
Mm-hmm.
And the stuff that with x that would tell you the area is going to be equal to whatever expression would tell you the perimeter. They're equal to each other, and you can solve the equation.